how to import and export Rally data for Excel, Microsoft 365, and Excel 2016. This video will show you how to use the Rally add-in for Excel to import and export your data. The Excel 2016 Microsoft 365 add-in will only work with versions of Excel 2016 and Excel for Microsoft 365. If you have an older version of the Rally add-in for Excel, you can still install and use the Excel 2016 Microsoft 365 version. Queries created in the old add-in will not be automatically moved to the Excel 2016 add-in. Remember to check out the installation and user guide on the Rally Help site for full instructions on how to install the add-in. In this video, you'll learn how to log into the add-in, export work items from a Rally project, use filters to export specific work items, import new work items, and import work item relationships. Once the add-in has been inserted into Excel, select Login and enter your username and password information to connect to your Rally subscription. Once Excel connects to Rally, you're able to begin importing and exporting data. The export function gives you several configuration options. You can extract all work items of a specific type from a project or use the filtering features to find unique sets of data. Start by selecting your workspace and project within the project scoping field. If you leave this field blank, the default workspace and project setting in your user profile will be used instead. Queries control what data is exported from your project and are saved with the workbook file. You can create sets of filter criteria for reuse by saving a master workbook. Choose an option from the type dropdown to select what kind of work item to export. Your choices may vary depending on your subscription level and configuration. The Columns field lets you choose which work item fields are returned in the export. Use the drop-down list to see a list of available fields and select the ones you want. If you do not check any boxes, all available fields will be displayed. The Filter field lets you define specific criteria. Only work items that meet those criteria will be exported. We will leave this field blank for now so that we can export all user stories in our specified project. The result limit will allow you to adjust how many results you would like to be exported from Rally. The default is 200. Using the Sort dropdown, specify a field to sort on, and then select whether the sort should be ascending or descending. Select the target sheet. The default is New Sheet, meaning that anytime a query is run, it will open a new sheet. You can change this to select an existing sheet, which will cause the resulting data to overwrite previously exported data. After you have set your project scoping, type, columns, filters, result limit, and sort item criteria, you will have the option to save your query parameters to use again later. Select Export once your query is ready. Let's see that export again with a few different options. Now we'll add a filter to our query so we can export a specific set of user stories. You can use the chooser to build a basic filter or manually type in your criteria using the same syntax supported by Rally Web Services API and the query field found in some customizable apps. You can find query examples within the Rally Online Help. The Import option provides you with a way to create large sets of work items in a single step. New work items will need to conform to the fields and settings that already exist in your workspace. The add-in will fetch these requirements so that you may format your Excel rows correctly. To get started, select Import from the Excel add-in pane. Select the project scoping for your import. The project scope is defined by the workspace and project where you want to import data. You can also scope up or scope down, or both. Select the type for your import from the drop-down list. Once you have selected the project scope and type, the add-in will then display the required fields. To ensure your spreadsheet is formatted correctly, you must use the Validate button before importing. The add-in will review the contents and show you which rows have invalid or missing entries. Once the data has passed validation, you can import it into Rally. When your import has completed, you will have the option to undo the import if you did something incorrectly, which will send all the items you just imported to the recycle bin in Rally. You can import user stories, tasks, and other work items that are associated with the existing work items in the workspace. This is done with fields such as parent and work product. For example, I want to import a set of stories and set them as children of an existing story in my workspace. This can be done by entering the formatted ID of the existing story into the parent field. To import a hierarchy of stories, a set of stories and their tasks, or other related work item sets, start by importing the topmost work item, get the name or ID from Rally, and then import the children or associated items. I'll start by importing two new user stories. And now I'll import a set of tasks assigned to those stories. You can refresh the exported data in one or more sheets using the selections in the Refresh tab. A refresh can only be done on sheets that were previously exported using the Excel add-in. The data in a sheet is updated using the same query parameters as the original export for that sheet. Selecting Refresh All Sheets collectively refreshes all of the listed sheets. Refresh an individual sheet by selecting the button for that sheet. Congratulations! Now you understand how to use the Rally Excel add-in to import and export data from Excel. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. Like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you'll never miss new content as it's added.